Back in the spring of 1988, the New York Islanders and New Jersey Devils met in the first round of the Eastern Conference playoffs. In game two, the Devils picked up their first ever postseason victory. Mark Johnson with the goal. The series evened at one. In game six, the Devils broke out to a huge lead. Patrick Sundstrom with one of the goals, but the Islanders made a furious rally, but they fell just short as Sean Burke stoned Pat LaFontaine. That Devils and Islanders hockey memory is presented by TD Waterhouse, the global online financial services firm. And Stan Fischler, you were there. What was that like?
Well, the thing that won it for the Devils was that they thoroughly intimidated the Islanders, and nothing said it more than Kenny Danico battering Patty LaFontaine throughout the series. And of course, there was really no retaliation. Denny Potvin was creamed against the boards on an icing chase. I remember that, and there was no retaliation. But the most exciting thing was that last game. There was only about 10 seconds left, and the faceoff was in the deep Islander zone, and Patty LaFontaine somehow got free, went right down the ice, and Sean Burke made a terrific save, and that was it.
6-5 the final score, the Devils with the victory. All right, so let's fast forward to this season. The Islanders come in, winners of three straight. What do you make of this club?
Islanders are going to make the playoffs. Islanders are going to be a tremendous challenge to the Devils. They are a team without any fear. They are a team right now that I believe is going to get better, because they went three straight and the Yashin line has done nothing. Now, when Yashin wakes up, which could be tonight, they're going to be even better than they are now, and they've got a very solid defense. But the one thing they're missing, and let me tell you that, they don't have a real tough guy in enforcer. Now, you take a look at that Pekka hit last night. Now, let me tell you something. If you had hit my friend or my teammate the way Pekka got hit, I would have gone out and I would have clocked you.
Well, we showed it a few moments ago, and here it is again. Mike Wilson, big guy, 6'6", bang. And Pekka goes down. He will not play tonight. You know, the reaction generally, though, from the Islanders was that it was maybe Pekka's fault. He even allowed as much, that maybe his head was down, crossing the line.
You aren't listening. I said, if you had done it to a teammate of mine, I would have clocked you. And that's what they need, somebody who can do it. Steve Webb is a game guy, but he is not really that type. The Devils have a Jimmy McKenzie. The Islanders don't have that type of guy. That is their one soft spot.
All right, a couple of issues from around the league. Buffalo, for the first time in many years, without Dominik Hasek in goal. Do they miss him?
Not a bit. And I'll tell you something. Detroit may regret that move. You know, Hasek had problems during the summer. The suspicion is that it was Lyme disease. And that could be debilitating for a while. And I'm telling you something, Buffalo, be fine without Hasek.
All right, we'll.
But I couldn't be fine without you. I don't want you to get upset that I wanted to clock you.
We will see how
theoretical
things develop, always in theory, down the road. Hey, the commissioner, Gary Bettman, will be here tonight, and you'll be chatting with him during the first intermission.
Do you know that he made a statement in a press conference about a week ago? He criticized the Yashin contract. I want to know where he comes off criticizing a team publicly.
Well, the gloves are off.
What goes?
Gloves are off. That's the first intermission, but we have more. However, it won't come from New Jersey. It'll come from our New York Sports Report studios. Mike Hill standing by. He'll get you caught up on what's going on in hockey.